So the project I've been working on this summer is investigating diet of blue catfish in the Nanticoke River here in Maryland as well as in Delaware. So we are aiming to look at what these fish are eating as they are invasive here in the Chesapeake Bay watershed. So they were introduced in the 1970s, and since then these blue catfish have really spread around the bay into basically every major tributary. So there's been some diet studies that looked at what they're eating down in the Western Shore in Virginia. However, our diet study wants to look at what they're eating over here on the Eastern Shore up here in the Nanticoke River. So the reason that we're concerned about what they're eating is because as invasive fish, we know that they can impact native species. So things that we care about here in Maryland, like striped bass, as well as blue crabs, and some of the other fish and invertebrate species here in Maryland. There's a delicate balance, as we know, in ecosystems. So we want to determine what impact these invaders will have on that balance within our ecosystem here. So for us, what we do is we collect those fish, and then we'll go back and at the lab or out in the field sometimes, depending on the day, we'll actually measure and weigh the fish, and then we'll remove the stomach, and then we'll take that stomach, we'll put it on ice, freeze it, and then back in the lab here at Salisbury this summer, and really the rest of this year, I've had the pleasure of going through, sifting through these stomachs and finding out and analyzing what's in them. To talk about the Nanticoke River Invasive Fishing Tournament, we put it on as a supplementary method of collecting fish for our diet study. So what normal method that we use is called boat electrofishing. So basically this is when researchers will go out, they'll use a boat that has a generator on it that essentially applies electrical current into the water. This causes fish to float up, and then we can easily net our catfish for our diet study. However, that's a very labor-intensive process, and we're not able to cover a huge geographic range in one day on the river, although we try our best. So to supplement our collection for our study, we chose to put on this tournament. And the reason that we were able to put this on was we actually received a grant from the Maryland Department of Natural Resources, an invasive species grant. And this allowed us to establish some prize money for the tournament, and as well as cover some of our expenses. So we put this tournament on as a free-to-enter tournament, so no entry fee required, anybody could come in. The stipulations of participating in this tournament were that you have to provide, at the end of the tournament, you have to give us your fish so that we can collect their stomachs, as well as tissue samples from each of those fish that were caught in the tournament. As part of the tournament, we collected, I believe, just about 1,000 invasive fish, so blue catfish and northern snakehead. This is like almost 10 times a normal sample. And we were fortunate that not only does this event function as something that collects data for our research, but it also serves as a removal effort for these invasive species.